I love to be at the scenes, what happened on that night. You know, about Jesus walking and flying around. How many of you ever had a privilege to be in Israel? Raise your hand. One person. You need to go there. You need to go there. When I was 2 years in the seminary, I had a privilege to go there for almost a little more than 2 months. I walked technically the way how Jesus walked. So one day I came upon the Sea of Galilee. It was a beautiful, it's huge. And I mean the wind was blowing, it's just like the ocean. You can see the wave after the wave. So I came to one of the service area, you know, where they have the boat ride, you know, they put you on a big boat. And so I came in there and I asked, so how much is a ticket for a boat ride? They gave me different price, you know, like $50 for this, and you know, for 45 minutes, you know, if you have dinner and that for 2 hours, you know, like 140, and all those prices. And I said, so the cheapest one you got is how much? He said, 45 minutes for $50. I said, no wonder why Jesus walked. He didn't have $50 for an hour, 45 minutes, man. No wonder why he walked. You know, the gospel opened with Jesus made them. What is that telling you and I? It's when they didn't want to go alone, or they didn't want to go yet. That tells you and tell me that the disciple, he was doing a lot of good things here. They want to hang around. They want to see what else coming up. Or they want to be part of that celebrityness of Jesus. Hey, I know him, I'm his disciple, don't you know that, huh? But so the gospel opened today telling us that Jesus made the disciple to get on a boat and go. Now they reluctantly did that because they don't want to. Guess what? A few hours later, when the wind come up, what do they say to each other in the boat? You see, he knew it. That's why he's not here now. He knew what's gonna come up and he leave us alone. They was complaining. Where is he now? Isn't that you and I, we do all the times in our life? When we go through some hardship, yeah, I follow him, you promised me, where are you, God? Why are you abandoning me? Why are you leaving me alone? And guess what? Jesus never left us alone. He always there. The first reading telling us today is a funny thing. They was looking for the Lord. Now the earthquake came, where is he? And we couldn't find him. Now, and then after the earthquake, what happened? The fire. There was nobody there. And Jesus whispered to them. But in this case, Jesus didn't whisper to them. He was like flying to them because he knows they are in trouble. And guess what? When he came, oh my goodness, here it come again. Here's another ghost. What's going to happen to us now? The master isn't here. He's busy doing whatever he's doing over there. But Jesus said, whoa, 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 wait a second. You've been with me this long, you couldn't even recognize me, man. Here, let me tell you. It is I, be not afraid. Now you may not see it, but when the voice come out, you may have heard that voice and you know that is. Many of you know, I just came back from Corpus, Missouri last night. And that's a small town, a town half of the size of America's. But every year, the first week of August, beginning from Wednesday, there will be around 80 to 120,000 Vietnamese in this country, Canada, and around the world, gathered for a pyramid. This is their 34th annual. And I'm honored to be there. The last 3 years, I gave the keynotes there for the youth. I'm doing it this year. I'm coming back again and doing it next year. It's a great honor to do so. But you know, when I'm up there in that width of 80,000 people, they don't see me, you know? They can see that little guy moving up there and moving pretty fast. So they kind of like, I'm okay. But they hear my voice when I'm talking to them. So after I'm preaching, I'm wandering around on the street, and you know, like mingling into that. And then when I'm walking by and everybody, is that the guy who was just up there? You know, they're not sure when they look at me. But when they hear that I'm talking to someone, they recognize the voice. They say, well, that's him, that's him. Because they have heard that voice many times. That's why Jesus spoke today. He said, it is I, be not afraid. Unfortunately, they were too afraid. They couldn't even recognize his voice. They couldn't even recognize his voice. I love Peter, the guy who opened his mouth say anything. I'm just like him. Whatever come out. I was talking to Monsignor Lucree this morning, and he said, well, what happened in the diocese? I said, you're the bishop. I like that. And I said, oh, no, no. He said, what did you mean? I said, well, if any guy has spoken, you cannot be close friend with the leadership. They was too frightened. They couldn't recognize his voice. But Peter also heard that familiar voice. He's not sure, so he wanna make sure. Because he know his master can do a lot of good things. So he said, whoa, Jesus, if it's you, why don't you tell me to do what you doing now? Jesus said, come. So Peter, so high up, jumped out the boat and run it. Flying. He was doing fine until he like, oh my God, what am I doing here? He looked around and he began to worry again. He see the strong wind coming up. He see the wave is about to take his life. And then he began to go down. He was okay until he took his eyes off the Lord and began to look around to see what's going on. And I'm not just talking about the physical eyes here. I'm talking about he took his mind, his heart away from the one he should be coming and seeing. Then he went down. But that guy's still pretty smart. As he going down, he said, hey, help me, Lord, I'm going down. How often you and I, we can do this thing? Can we call on that name every time we feel we're going down? Or we're going to complain even more because I am going down. You told me to come, and here I'm dying. Why don't you do something about it? He called and said, Lord, help me. Jesus reached out the hands, pulled the guy up from the water. That's one of the jokes they hear all the time between the Catholic and the Protestant. They say, you know why, you know, they said that they was telling the jokes that the priest and the older minister was talking, and they challenged this order to walk on the water. So every guy come down, walk the field, they fell out. When the priest jumped down, he walked, poop, 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 on the water. And people said, how did you do that? He said, I didn't walk on water, I got the rock on the beach. I got the rock. Jesus alone is the rock. He's the rock that keeps you and I above the water. Jesus alone that you and I need to keep our heads on, our eyes forward. There are times in your life and my life we will go in there. Let us call out and say, Lord, help me. There are times that we're not sure if he's there, but it's better that we need to hear his voice. And how do we hear his voice unless we learn how to listen? To listen to his word. The first reading tells us today, he was whispering. Sometimes we are too busy to do that. Sometimes we're too busy to listen to him. They already asked me to come back next year, the first week of August, to do the talk. I already gave them the first topic. Can you hear me now? Not to advertise the horizon, right? All the kids know. Can you hear me now? In this wonderful time, can we hear the voice of God talking to us? Because there are too many voices around us. The voice of televisions, of the ding-dong of the text messages, the voice of a movie, of music. Every time as you see them on the street, they walking with all those ears blocked. I said, when you turn 50, you're dead. Try this. Last night I get back at 10 o'clock, I landed in Atlanta. And I took the train to go out. And in my train had probably 20 people. And I count, 14 of them have the, whatever you call this thing, to hear the music. And I'm talking like he was over there, like 4 feet away, and I'm here, and I hear the music. I said, you deaf, man. And he didn't hear what I said, because he was already deaf. So can we hear, can you hear me now? Can you hear that? We have to hear that voice of God. We need to recognize that voice talking to us all the time. And what he's saying, it is, I, be not afraid. That's what he's saying. Come to me. That's what he's saying. So my dear friends, I think you got my message for this mass. Open, listen. We cannot recognize him with our eyes. Let's see him, hear him, and recognize him in the word. Because he continued to talk to us, not just from the time of creation, not 2,000 years just walking, but today and every day. He's talking to you and to me. So, can you hear me now?